God damn.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 Bruce Lee fight scenes.
Watch him none, watch him chuck, watch him none, watch him chuck. Oh, look at a screamer. We put in a Green Hornet clip?
For this list, we'll be looking at those fight scenes that helped immortalize Bruce Lee.
I just realized, this is probably a bunch of Green Hornet fights I never watched of Bruce Lee's. They're probably not as good as the stuff he did in his movies, but...
Which is your favorite Bruce Lee fight? Let us know in the comments. Number 10, Chen Zhen versus Petrov, Fist of Fury.
I thought this would be higher. I really like this fight. The Petrov is the mini-boss in Fist of Fury. And in my opinion, this is like the best fight in the movie, except for the iconic dojo fight, which I'm sure we'll see higher up. But besides the dojo fight where he rinses all those those black belts in their own dojo, this is my favorite one-on-one fight, Chen Zhen versus Petrov.
Let me take care of him.
Size does not always make a difference.
He's a big white man.
Fist of Fury places Bruce Lee's Chen in a string of lopsided battles, only for the martial artist to prove repeatedly that no odds are insurmountable. Nearing the climax of the film, Chen takes on a Russian powerhouse known for bending metal bars. In an exciting battle of styles and temperaments, Chen responds to each one of Petrov's powerful attacks with vicious strikes and kicks that leave the Russian constantly on the ropes. Although by no means brief, this fight is shockingly one-sided.
Oh wow, he went for a number. I mean, he landed some blows on Jackie.
Mr.
He landed some blows on Bruce Lee, I apologize. He landed some blows on Bruce Lee as a mini-boss, so he did okay.
Mr. Lee and Roper versus Han's men. Enter the Dragon.
Yeah,
as Enter the Dragon reaches its conclusion, Han's private martial arts tournaments erupts into a massive brawl after Roper takes out the crime lord's main guard.
This kick sequence is always lit.
Roper and Mr. Lee come together to take on an army of Han's goons, with the heroes eventually being aided by a group of prisoners held captive on the island. The whole sequence is chaotic and a sight to behold, with Lee looking in full control as he takes on multiple opponents without breaking a sweat.
I just love how all these guys have black belts on, like as if they're all black belts and they're all getting fucking washed.
Lee probably could have taken on all of Han's henchmen on his own. Number 8, Chen Zhen versus Hiroshi Suzuki, Fist of Fury.
Right, so after he kills the big white guy, Petrov, yeah, I never knew his name. Now he has to fight the final boss, the Japanese, older Japanese man with sword. Katana, it's katana, he's, you know. But it doesn't go great for him.
Everything in Fist of Fury is leading up to the battle between Jingwu School's Chen Zhen and the Hongku Dojo's master, Hiroshi Suzuki. A scheming murderer directly responsible for the death of Chen's teacher, Suzuki fearfully hides behind a katana as he desperately tries to keep the hero and his nunchucks at a distance. The weapons represent the conflicting ideologies of the Jingwu School and the Hongku Dojo, while Chen smashing Suzuki multiple times in the face represents, well, that the protagonist is not especially fond of his opponent.
Man, the way he throws those nunchucks into that attack, it's just so fucking... Oh, that's good stuff. It's so full of hate. Intense hatred. Let's watch that shit again. Look at this. Look, he knocks the shorter. Look how he throws it. Look how he smashes that lamp.
While the fight is on the shorter side, every blow stresses the fact that Chen and Suzuki want to kill each other. And one of them eventually succeeds.
Yeah, the thing about this fight, like, the Petrov fight goes longer and is more competitive because Bruce Lee just watches this old man. Yeah! Flying kick! Get fucking wrecked, bro! Get fucked! Get fucked!
Number 7, Mr. Lee versus Han, Enter the Dragon. Following a solid fight that ends with a spear stuck in a wall, Lee chases Han into a room of mirrors. More of a psychological than a physical fight, Lee and Han engage in a cat-and-mouse contest as the hero struggles to pick out the real villain from the many illusions caused by the mirrors. Bolstered by splendid cinematography and an intensity that does not let up for a second, Enter the Dragon's final battle stands out as a unique experience in Bruce Lee's impressive catalog of cinematic action scenes.
Jumping kick!
Nope.
So, me and Joe from the Spirit Hunters pod talked about this. That mirror scene, though iconic, is very overrated with the whole Enter the Dragon thing. It is literally smoke and mirrors to make up for the fact that I don't think Han's actor could really fight anymore. He just had a claw hand and a bear hand and a spear. And yeah, he's no match for Bruce Lee physically, so they just, like, put him in a thing of mirrors. And it's like, it's not really a fight. It's like a fucking cat and mouse chase. But if I can be nitpicky, I feel like I've always felt like that whole scene was very overrated, even though it is iconic. You know, but
number 6, Bruce Lee as Billy Low versus Dan Inosanto as Pasquale.
This is
Game of Death.
And find one of his students, I think? Dan Inosanto? Or maybe one of his peers?
As just a percentage of Game of Death was filmed before Bruce Lee's untimely passing, who knows how much of Bruce's original vision is captured in the completed version? If the immaculate fight scene pitting Lee against Dan Inosanto is anything to go by, Game of Death was going to be something special.
It was going to be really good. The stuff we get with Bruce is dope.
The two masters craft a flawlessly paced encounter that is just as much about the gaps between the blows as it is about the hits themselves.
The nunchuck off is sick.
Locked in a game of chess with nunchucks, each move made by Lee and Inosanto is calculated, suspenseful, and gripping. Number 5, Chen Chaoan versus Xiao Mi, the Big Boss.
This should be lower. This fight's kind of weird. It was a clashing of styles. Bruce Lee was coming from like a... I mean, he was reinventing the wheel. He was doing that new shit. And the big boss, the titular big boss here, was... He's an old school. He's an old school, you know, Hong Kong fighter guy. So he didn't do anything wrong. It's just there was a clash of generations and styles.
Also known as Fists of Fury, the big boss puts Bruce...
It's confusing because this is the big boss, but it was released as Fist of Fury in some places. But then there's the real Fist of Fury, which is Bruce Lee's second movie where he fights the Japanese guy and the white guy. So
Bruce Lee on the map as an action movie star. Centering around a drug trade operating out of an ice factory, the film culminates with a brutal battle pitting Lee's Chen Chaoan against Xiao Mi, the titular Big Boss. Marked by a vicious intensity that arguably none of Lee's subsequent movies would replicate, This bloody fight blends stellar stunt work with strategy and storytelling.
It is pretty brutal. I will give it that. It is pretty brutal. Very violent. He loves that flying kick. Big move.
Xiao Mi grows more fearful of Chang and desperate as the battle progresses, culminating in a fantastic and narratively complimentary final move. Number four.
Yeah, he throws the knife. Bruce Lee kicks it back at him. It's not my favorite ending. No, I'm not gonna lie to you. It's not my favorite ending. But, it, you know... Oh, here we go.
Four, Mr. Lee versus O'Hara, yeah. Enter the Dragon. This is less of a contest and more of a prolonged execution. Mr. Lee meets O'Hara, the man responsible for his sister's death, in a shady martial arts tournament, and then proves that revenge is a dish best served with multiple blows to the head.
It's like when you really see how fast Bruce Lee was, they would show this clip of him throwing that short punch.
Best served with multiple blows to the head. While Bob Walls O'Hara presents an imposing figure, the martial artist is absolutely dismantled by Lee. Once the desperate killer brings a broken bottle into play, O'Hara's fate is sealed. There are plenty of more complex fight scenes, but this battle effectively tells a story and highlights Bruce Lee's acting chops, all while still including jaw-dropping moves.
Damn. And then this classic finisher. Off-screened. Off-screen stopped.
Number three, Tong Lung versus Colt, Way of the Dragon.
This is number three? This is number one? So I couldn't even do Jabbar's up there, obviously. That's one or two. What the fuck else is the, Oh, probably the dojo, we still haven't done the dojo fight. Yeah, that shit's iconic, so, okay.
In The Way of the Dragon's climax, Bruce Lee's Tong Lung faces off against Chuck Norris's Colt in a fight for the ages. Set in Rome's Colosseum, this is a true battle of the Goliaths as two masters earn each other's respect while holding absolutely nothing back. Tong comes across as unstoppable in most fights, but Colt gets plenty of good licks in, making the hero's eventual dominance all the more impressive.
Chuck combination! Grab chest hair. Reversal. Bruce Lee can make grabbing a man's chest hair and blowing it off your hand look cool. What a fucking legend.
Lee gets to show off a wide range of moves, be it body chops or low kicks, while Norris helps ensure the fight is mesmerizing every step of the way.
Look how fast he was with that arm break. Look at this shit again. Look at him, look right here. He broke his arm. His hand speed was insane! Bruce Lee was so fucking fast. Like, Chuck Norris is like, you know, like a real motherfucker. He's a real world martial arts champion. And he's not as fast as Bruce Lee. You know, I mean, it's screen fighting. It's different, obviously. But, goddamn, bro. I'll give also Chuck Norris props. Not a lot of real fighters make good screen fighters. But with the right people behind him, Chuck Norris was more than competent screen fighter. This is one of his best fights still, this Bruce Lee fight, obviously.
Number two, the Hongku Dojo fight, Fist of Fury. Following an intense and frustrating opening segment that involves representatives of a Japanese dojo mocking the deceased master of the Jingwu school, Chen decides to get some revenge.
I love when people say that. I alone will be enough.
More than two dozen students attempt to overwhelm Chen, only for each one of them to be taught an emphatic lesson. expertly choreographed to ensure each moment flows seamlessly to the last, this sequence is enthralling from beginning to end.
What?
It beats everyone's ass. Bruce Lee invented fucking up all, a bunch of black belts. Like, Jet Li does it in Fist of Legend, the remake. And then Donnie Yen has the recent one in It Man, but Bruce Lee invented, I'm gonna fuck up a bunch of karate people.
Things only get better when Chen brings out the nunchucks, causing the students to collectively wish their dojo used brown gi.
Get it? Because they all shit themselves. Well done. Oh. Dance, motherfuckers, dance!
Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions. Bruce Lee as Billy Lowe
versus honorable
Kareem
mention?
Abdul-Jabbar as...
What the fuck's number one? Wait a minute. Wait, that's an honorable mention? That's not even the top 10? This assuredly should have been in the top 10.
Takeem, Game of Death, because the size difference is a sight to behold.
Is it gonna be the factory fight? Cause I thought that should be on here, but I didn't think it should be number one. It's the best fight in the Big Boss.
Underground fight, Enter the Dragon, because this fight builds up steam nicely and features a young Jackie Chan.
It does, it's a classic. There he is, there he is, there's our boy. There's Jackie being manhandled by a legend.
The alley fight with weapons, Way of the Dragon.
Yeah, this is cool too.
Because these gangsters are so outmatched, it is almost hilarious.
Get him!
There's also a really good fight before he fights before he fights Chuck Norris. He fights Wong Yin Sik and Bob Wall again, or Bob O'Hara again. They're the two mini bosses he fights. And those fights are really good. But those wouldn't be number one ahead of the Chuck Norris fight, would they? What am I not remembering?
Tong Lung versus two martial
yeah,
artists.
Yeah, this is the two I'm thinking
Way
about.
Way of
yeah.
the Dragon. Because Wong each Sik kick lands with incredible power. Kato versus Lo Sing, the Green Hornet.
I just rewatched
this preview of things to come.
I just watched this movie for the, one of the first times. It's pretty wild to see.
Ice Factory fight.
This is number one?
Number one, the Ice Factory fight.
I can't believe this is number one.
Putting aside a very brief fight that serves as a teaser of things to come, the Big Boss holds back on its Bruce Lee until the movie's final act.
It does.
Then, Lee's Chang takes on the Big Boss's son and a gaggle of goons in an ice factory, creating history in the process.
And he has a knife. The thing that's brutal, this movie is, like, violent and one of the more brutal Bruce Lee movies. He's got a fucking knife this whole time. He's, like, killing people.
Along with being the first major cinematic showcase of Lee's martial arts, this sequence amplifies its dynamic stunt work with innovative use of weaponry and a willingness to get bloody. Tiny character moments like Cheng tasting his own blood supplement the action splendidly, while there's just something satisfying about seeing Lee punch a guy through a wall.
Hadouken!
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent...
I mean, he did punch a guy through a wall. It's kind of hard to argue after he punches a man through a wall, because it's pretty... But yeah, no, this is clearly... The thing is, this is definitely one of Bruce Lee's weaker movies, because it's got not as much Bruce Lee. They hold back on him to the third act. But this fight is cool. It would definitely be in the top 10 for me, but not number one. I think definitely Bruce Lee versus Chuck Norris is a masterpiece. And I think his fights with Wong Yin Sik and Bob O'Hara right before that are almost as good. So those would be my top two. And then the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar thing is really lit. And the Dan and Soto, the nunchuck off, is also really good. And the dojo fight. Those would be my top five. The dojo. So, yeah, weird list. No, I don't really agree with this list too much. But, you know, watch Mojo. You know, they did what they could.